WNBA Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the WNBA.
Hey everyone, and welcome to the WNBA on 2K Sports. And tonight it'll be the Phoenix Mercury going up against the Seattle Storm. Courtside with Tim Schwartz and Brian Benefitini. I'm Blake Cuniga, and we've got a fun one. And so off the tip, it's Phoenix. Well, guys, we're finally here. Game one of the WNBA Finals.
Yeah, breathe it in. This is an amazing environment, an amazing game. Big-time matchup tonight, Blake. I'm looking for a team to come out of the gates firing. Light this place up with some offense.
Love it, Tim. But I'm looking at the defensive side of the ball. Who is going to put their foot down early? A lot of storylines in this one, so I hope you guys brought your popcorn. If not, don't worry, because I brought a lot.
Now here's Diggins Smith. Four on the clock. Here's the three. Not gonna go that time. Good D by Natasha Howard. Bird. Howard. Back to Bird. And she uses the glass on the layup.
Not an easy basket from Bird, but she has tremendous body control. It's helped her throughout the years.
Outside, Diggins Smith. Pass to Breland. To Rossi. Shoots the three. Can't get it to fall, and she's missed her second after making her first. She was fouled in the act of shooting, an opportunity for a three-point play.
You can't let her get a shot off in that situation. Howard can finish with contact. Plus, she's a pretty solid foul shooter.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. 1 second.
Voted most improved player in 2018, Natasha Howard shot 55% from the field, easily set a career scoring average mark, and was on the all-defensive team.
A nice shot by Diggins Smith. And the Storm with possession. Pass to Stewart. Clark outside. Bird outside. Let's go with a three. That shot off the mark. And it's Phoenix the other way. Goes back up. A nice shot by Diggins Smith.
Coaches love to see hustle, aka what Diggins Smith is all about. And I love how she's just always infusing a winning attitude for her team.
Now here is Lloyd. Bird right side. There's the steal. Here's Diggins Smith, and Clark pulls it down.
Those chances, usually they're 2 points for her. The D, I guess, did just enough to bother her.
And a basket by Lloyd.
Dropping dimes, Bird has incredible vision and feel. She sees the whole court.
Pass to Breland. Coffee. She's covered by Clark. There's the foul. It's on Howard. That's her first foul. Side, Diggins Smith.
You know, it's not been the best quarter for her as far as scoring. We'll see if she can get back on track.
Pass to Stewart. The shot's good on the assist by Drew Lloyd.
Tremendous find by Lloyd. She's really a combo guard, but she has point guard savvy. Senses when her teammates are open.
Now here's Diggins Smith. Here's Griner. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. Brianna Stewart picks one up. Two free throws.
first free throw is good.
The late blossoming of her offense has been incredible. Griner, her scoring average improved by 5 points during season 5 in the WNBA.
And she can't hit the second. Seattle leading. Here's Bird. And Brittany Griner with the block.
Such a strong defensive prowess. I love how Griner makes shooters dig not once, not twice, probably at least 3 times before shooting the rock around her.
Now here's Bird. Outside Lloyd. From way back. Diana Taurasi grabs the miss. Here's Coffey. Alicia Clark with the defensive effort.
Great looking defense to throw off her shot.
Yeah, turned it from a simple, straightforward look into a very difficult shot.
And so here's Phoenix. They trail by one. Taurasi with it. Bird picks her up. Left side, Diggins Smith. 5 on the clock. Taurasi outside. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Natasha Howard. That's foul number 2 for her. Seattle on D. Pass to Coffey. Down low. Here's Griner. And stolen by Canada. Howard inside. He's guarded by Hartley. Back to Howard. Whitcomb. Stewart inside. Griner's there. Stewart can't hit.
That's the kind of D that's needed when she's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over her.
Pass to Hartley. Here's Breland.
Whitcomb defending.
Shot clock at 6. Taurasi. That one a little long.
The defense can't make a habit of giving her that shot. She just doesn't miss many of them.
Outside Stewart. That's good for her 3rd bucket. Now 3 for 6 from the field.
They're just killing them in the paint.
You can say that again. I mean, the defenders aren't being nearly aggressive enough down low.
They're just killing them in the paint.
Thank you.
Now here's Griner. Hartley drills it from outside. And that ties it up.
Good find by Griner. She's so much taller than everybody at 6'9". It allows her really to see the rest of the court.
On the wing, Sammy Whitcomb. He's covered by Taurasi.
Here's Howard. And so she draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2.
That's where she wants the ball. Howard is such a high percentage shooter. She gets into good spots, forces fouls.
This is her 2nd trip to the free throw line in this one.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
The first one falls. She picks up just 1 from the line that time.
They got that one, but early on, they're struggling to secure the boards.
But it's still early. I wouldn't read too much into it. Still plenty of game ahead.
Yeah, time to get that right.
Here's Turner. Pass to Hartley.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Russell. That is the first foul of the game.
Here's Hartley. Turner, guarded by Russell. Inside. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Here's Hartley. Oh, and she misses the go-ahead basket. Pass to Canada. to Whitcomb. Pulls it. That one rolling around and rims out. To the middle. Here's Hartley. She can't get that one to fall. Now Seattle takes it the other way. To the paint. It's stolen by Breland. Hartley outside. Pass to Breland. Here's Turner. Walker Kimbrough. Over Canada. And again, Phoenix no good. To the right side. Whitcomb. Russell. She's guarded by Hartley. Here's Stewart. Pass to Russell. Solid play on the low block, and that one's good.
The defenders didn't really even get a sniff of her on that move to the iron.
Breland with the ball. Here's Turner, defended by Stewart. Now here's Hartley. Tight defense on her. Walker Kimbrough misses.
Rebounding is going to be a focal point for them in this one, fellas.
Yeah, Brian, it has been so far. They've already got a nice edge on the glass.
Now here is Canada. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Fires from 14. Goes up again. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the line.
He got caught standing around that time and giving up the second chance points.
They need more effort than that on the boards. That can't happen.
Absolutely.
What's up?
And so the first quarter in the books. It's the Storm. They lead by six. And quarter two will get underway just after this short break. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen from the Storm?
Simple. Defense so far. And they have really clamped up.
Say it one more time, Tim. Defense. Every shooter that challenges their defense has had a hand in their face.
Seattle in the lead. Outside Stewart. The Storm rebound. Russell with the bucket.
And they continue to control the glass.
I think they've been the more physical team, guys, and that's why they're ahead.
Usually the more physical, more aggressive team wins the game.
Here's Turner. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Outside Canada. Here's Stewart. And that's good. A nice job on the glass, and they pick up the two on the second effort.
They're doing a terrific job of getting the ball inside, attacking the paint. That's an area, and it's a key area on the court they control.
Yeah, once they identified what an edge they had inside, they just continued to attack.
Now here is Stewart. 10-point lead. This is their biggest lead. We're about a minute and a half into the second quarter now, and it's in.
She's got a great read of where that miss was going, and that enabled her to be the first player to it and get the putback.
Here's Griner. Pass to Hartley. Six on the shot clock. Good on the three-point shot.
Yeah, you might not think of her as a true ace from three-point range, but the shot was there for her.
The Storm with the ball. In the second quarter, they've given up just 3 points. Here's Russell. It's rebounded by Phoenix.
The defense was ready for her, got a hand in her face, and made that one much tougher.
And that's something that every team needs, rugged interior defense to just make your opponent think twice about coming down the lane.
Now here's Diggins Smith. He's got six. Pass to Canada from deep. She's off on that one. Now Phoenix takes it the other way. Here's Walker Kimbrough. Yes, and it's Skylar Diggins Smith with the assist that time.
They are absolutely stroking it from beyond the arc.
Now here is Lloyd. Turner grabs the board. Phoenix trailing here. Here's Diggins Smith. No, it does not. She's 3 for 9 now and pretty frustrated. Now here is Canada. D right on her.
Yeah, she tried to fight her way through traffic and just couldn't do it.
Walker Kimbrough. Good work defensively by Brianna Stewart. Outside Canada. Lloyd. Looking to end the drought. Now Diggins Smith. Pass to Turner. Here's Walker Kimbrough. Here's Greiner. The second chance effort. And she lays it up and in.
What an instinctual nose for the ball. Greiner just cleans up the glass so efficiently.
Outside Lloyd. And it's Phoenix with the rebound. Still anybody's game at this point.
No question, this becomes a very big possession.
Pass to Turner. Diggins Smith. Fades and shoots. Reiner shot is off.
The way she's been going this quarter, they're going to need someone else to pick up the slack.
A shot by Canada, no good.
She has yet to hit a shot this quarter and really just can't get it.
Over to the left wing. Here's Reiner. And there's another one for the Mercury.
Honestly, when she hits from this area of the court, you might as well quit. It makes Greiner almost impossible to stop. You just can't leave her out there.
Time called here. The Storm decide to talk it over.
Well, the coaches, they clearly don't like what's going on there, and they want to talk things over.
And why wouldn't they talk things over? I mean, really, you had to take a timeout there and just try to take away some of the opponent's momentum.
Howard. Bird guarded by Diggins Smith. Pass to Russell. They need this. The shot's good. Alicia Clark making the play.
An attentive player who sees the floor well. Clark really understands how to distribute the rock.
Here's Diggins Smith. Basket good.
How good is that? Man, she can make a defender look foolish with moves like that.
Pass to Lloyd. Russell. Bird outside. And she lobs up toward the rim. To the inside. And that one's good. Coffee. And that'll tie this game up.
Reads the defense so well. It's really what makes Diggins Smith the top-notch point guard she is.
Pass to Howard. Bird. And here's Russell. Back
to Bird.
Five to shoot. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Storm will get the ball here.
And the Storm making a change here.
Just three to shoot. And Brittany Griner with the block. And even three on three break. And she makes good on the layup.
Yeah, just doing much better now. First quarter, they converted less than 30% of their field goals, but they've bounced back here.
Pass to Russell. Clark. Up top, Bird. Guarded by Diggins Smith. Outside, Whitcomb. Misses the three. Phoenix in the lead. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing in control.
Here's Diggins Smith, and the Mercury tack on two more.
Effectively scans the defense. Diggins Smith puts her high basketball IQ to good use.
Sammy Whitcomb goes in. Right side, Howard. Over Griner. That shot by Howard, no good.
We haven't seen them get to the line as much here in the second quarter, and they might be settling a little bit too often offensively.
I think you're right, Tim. An up fake here or an up fake there, getting inside, that's how you create high percentage offense.
Yeah, you got to mix things up a bit.
Seattle calls timeout.
I think the coach has to be frustrated by their lack of production offensively, and I can't blame them. They're getting the looks, but the shots just aren't falling.
And it's at the point where this slump is going to take a mental toll on them. It's a good timeout to try to keep them from getting too discouraged.
And they've gotten the looks, they've gotten open, but they just can't get them to fall.
Whitcomb. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Out to the right wing. Pass to Howard. Now here's Bird. Just five on the clock. Alicia Clark on the wing. No good. Unable to end this run. Now Hartley. Reeland. Griner. Pass to Taurasi. From deep. And again, Phoenix with the triple.
Well played right there. There's no question which team has the momentum.
It does look like this lead is headed north.
On the wing, Sammy Whitcomb. 13 feet out. It's rebounded by Phoenix.
This offense, it just seems completely deflated.
While at the other end, it's one bucket after another. This run is really getting out of hand.
Making it ugly.
Reeland, left side, shoots over Bird. The bank shot, no good. Pass to Howard. Bird with it. It's good.
Smart's go a long way, and Bird has learned how to navigate under the hoop. Even standing at 5'9", she can score inside.
The clock runs out, and we're heading to halftime. It's the Mercury, up by 7. And we'll see you right after halftime for the beginning of the third quarter.
Nice gaze. Great performance by Skylar Diggins-Smith.
I know we've said it about a million times already, but I'll say it again. She's had a great half. Scored a lot of points.
And in the end, I wouldn't be surprised if we're talking about what a great second half she had. She can usually keep it going for all four quarters.
All right, the second half beginning in a moment. The Storm trail. Outside Lloyd. Pass to Clark. Stewart. Right side Howard. The shot will not fall. Excellent D there from Brittany Griner. Outside Diggins-Smith. Now here's Griner. She's covered by Clark. Back to Taurasi. Sets the 3-5. Drains it from downtown.
That's two bombs in a row from long range. They're starting to heat up.
The defense has stepped slow. They've got to take away that airspace.
Now here's Clark. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her.
Look, I'm a fan of Clark's willingness to absorb contact. And the best part is she's not a bad free throw shooter either.
It's her first trip to the line.
Two shots.
And she knocks down the first one.
Majored in electronic media journalism in college. Clark might be coming for our job soon.
That's also good, so she hits them both. And here in the second half of play, we're just over a minute in. Now here's Diggins-Smith, guarded by Bird. Pass to Coffey. Now here's Griner. Buries it down low.
In the paint, Griner simply unstoppable. She's so tall at 6'9", but she also has lovely touch.
Now here is Stewart. 8 points for her. And here is Bird. Here's Clark. The left wing. Shot clock at 5. Here's Stewart. And that one goes long. And here the Mercury. Taurasi with it. Picked up by Lloyd. Here's Diggins-Smith. Tries again. And count the basket. She was fouled. And she's going to the line for one more. And the Storm making a change here. And here's Canada. Quiet so far offensively, searching for her first points of the game. Pass to Stewart. Out to Lloyd. From downtown! And again, it's the Storm missing.
Three straight misses here to start the second half. Is that good?
Rossi outside. Diggins-Smith with it. Howard's there.
That's an excellent box out, keeping herself between the opposing players and the basket.
And Stewart gets it to go.
The easy look off the pass from Howard. Great awareness leads to the bucket.
Now here's Diggins-Smith. 12 points for her. Pass to Coffey from downtown. And it's Seattle with the rebound.
Oh, man. That's one she'd like to have over.
Yeah. Count it.
Yeah, coaches fall in love with Clark's demeanor because she means business when she's on the court.
Now here's Diggins-Smith. Back to Taurasi. Pulls back up. And a layup good by Griner.
That's something they need to do more of. Get after it on the glass.
It certainly wouldn't hurt. Some extra possessions would definitely help narrow the gap.
Now a timeout called by Seattle.
It's been quite the game for Diggin Smith.
He has absolutely worn them out in the paint. They need to come up with a plan to limit the damage she's doing inside.
Third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. Pass to Howard. Stewart. Outside Lloyd. Langhorne. Fades back. Rebounded by Walker Kimbrough. To the middle. Here's Griner. Goes up and lays it in nice and easy.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now. I mean, there's more holes in their defense than in a block of Swiss cheese.
Yeah, you just made me hungry. That's right. Five of the last six makes were in tight. They've established themselves inside. Where's the cheese?
Now here's Taurasi. 9 points in the game. And it's the storm on the break. Here's Canada. And a great assist by Brianna Stewart as that one goes in.
That was a heads-up play by Stewart. Look, the bottom line, she's a playmaker.
Pass to Coffey. Taurasi. Griner with the ball. Guarded by Howard. They double-team Brittany Griner. Here's Walker Kimbrough. And it's out of bounds. The Mercury able to retain possession here. The Storm making a switch here. Jacks up a three. Here's Griner. And she drops in the layup off glass.
Since halftime, she's been on fire.
Outside Canada. Outside Stewart. And Brittany Griner with the block. They get it back. Phoenix leading. The shot, no good. Jewel Lloyd with some nice D. Here's Howard. That shot missing. Now Phoenix takes it the other way. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game. And the basket by Walker Kimbrough.
She's top five in assists all time for a reason. Taurasi rarely makes the wrong choice.
Pass to Canada. Howard. She's guarded by Griner. Brianna Stewart from outside. In the Storm, another three.
Offensively, she can be the engine that drives them at any given moment.
Here's Turner, defended by Stewart. Clock at six. Here's Taurasi. Natasha Howard pulls it in. And it's Seattle scoring again.
The closer to the hoop, the better Howard is. Tremendous touch plus athletic ability.
Taurasi with it. Stewart's there. Here's Coffey. Plenty of contact on the shot, so the two free throws coming up. And Seattle gets called for the foul. And she's got her first free throws of the night right here.
Shooting two.
Good on the second free throw.
Seattle trailing here. Pass to Howard. Outside Stewart. Outside Canada. To the paint. Howard. Excellent D there from Brittany Griner. And here the Mercury. Inside. Nice pass. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup.
She is showing a killer instinct this quarter. Looking to extend this lead.
Pass to Whitcomb. And here is Howard. And foul called as she misses. And she's going to shoot two free throws. It's going to go on Brittany Griner.
She's gotten so much better at getting free throws. Howard has significantly increased her trips to the line over the last few years. Learning to draw contact.
She sinks the second. Rossi with it. She's got nine. Pass to Griner. Back to Taurasi. Here's Walker Kimbrough. Four on the shot clock. No good from 18.
Well, she rushed that one. The D was out of position, but she couldn't make him pay.
And that one's good.
You can always depend on her to put that lead pass right on the money.
Pass to Griner. Now Hartley. And no good. Excellent D there from Mercedes Russell. Now here is Stewart. Third outside. Russell with it. Stewart. Stripped it away. Taurasi with it. Stewart's there. A shot by Taurasi. No good.
You know, it might be a poor shooting performance for her, but luckily her teammates have picked up the slack.
Pass to Walker Kimbrough. Now Taurasi. Defended by Stewart. Off target from three-point range.
Yeah, I mean, she has been way off the mark this quarter. It is getting rough.
And we've watched three so far in this one. Mercury out in front, up by five. We'll be right back to the action when we return. Anything. All right, we welcome you back to what's been a hard-fought battle. Fourth quarter should be good. Phoenix in the lead. Here's Diggins Smith. The floater. Good work defensively by Sammy Whitcomb. Third left side. Pass to Whitcomb. Six to shoot. Shoots over Taurasi. And it's blocked by Diana Taurasi. Outside for Diggins Smith. Yes, and a nice assist from Diana Taurasi.
Well, precise decision-making has to be one of Diggins Smith's standout talents. I mean, she really has a deep knowledge of the game.
Bird with it. Now Breland defending. And Breland is going to pick up the foul. That's foul number two for her. The Storm making a switch here. About 1 minute played here in the fourth quarter. Skylar Diggins-Smith with the steal. Ahead. Here's the teardrop. Yep, that goes.
Well, after she had a tough first half, it's been a different story since the break.
Now here's Bird. She's guarded closely. And there's the call on Brittany Griner. That's her fourth foul of the contest. Right side, Stewart. Just five to shoot. Down low. It's stolen by Griner.
She's lost her way a little bit here in the second half. I mean, she was turnover free before the break, but that is simply not the case anymore.
Tipped. Oh. And the shot counts. She's fouled. That's a chance for a three-point play.
It's just so hard to stop Stewie. She has the strength to take the contact and get the basket. At 6'4", that's not fair.
The number one pick in the 2016 WNBA draft, Stewart made an immediate impact on the league, earning Rookie of the Year honors.
Griner, guarded by Howard. Griner with the ball. Howard's there. Shot clock at five. Diggin Smith. And it's Seattle with the rebound. Right side, Stewart. Knocked away. And she banks in the layup.
What a great sight to see. Stewart doesn't need much to get going. And once she does, she is so tough to guard.
And the Mercury call time here.
Notice the squad was starting to wear down and called timeout to let them get their lungs back.
On defense, Seattle. A four-point game. Natasha Howard with the block.
Amongst the best shot blockers in the WNBA, Howard's length is real trouble for opponents.
For those joining us, fourth quarter here, and we're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Now here's Bird. Pass to Lloyd. Excellent D there from Brittany Griner. And the Mercury with possession. They've only given up 5 points here in the fourth quarter. Diggin Smith, guarded by Bird. With the second effort, Diggin Smith's shot is off.
Tough D on the inside.
Sure was. No easy access to the bucket when she's in the middle.
To Hartley. Pass to Griner. Clock at six. Howard with the ball. He's picked up by Griner. And here's Clark. Bird outside. Right side, Howard. Three on the clock. And again, it's the Storm missing.
There's no way around it. It's been a difficult game for her offensively, and it has cost her team.
Hartley, left side. Diggin Smith. She's covered by Clark. Looking to get it going. The second effort. They get the rebound. Back to Diggin Smith. To the inside. Freeland with the bucket.
With the soft touch and springy legs, Freeland is a fantastic finisher around the basket.
Outside Howard. And howled hard that time. And she'll get two shots at the line.
Well, you allow someone to get to the rim like that, and really, that's the only option.
Yeah, free throws are always better than a layup. I would agree with that.
Taking two shots.
So both teams making some changes here.
And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
They've been making it look easy at the free throw line here in the second half.
Outside, Diggins Smith. Pulls it from 20. Offensive board.
Reiner, no good.
Seattle trailing here. Here's Howard. Rebounded by Coffey.
Yeah, and ever since halftime, she's been ice cold. Very little going her way out there.
On the wing, Jewel Lloyd. Pass to Howard. Outside Canada. Shoots over Diggins Smith. No good off the back of the rim. Here's Taurasi to the paint.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Jordan Canada.
That is her first foul of the game. Taurasi outside. Over to the wing. Six on the shot clock. Shot from 16.
Well, thus far, they managed to overcome an off team from her offensively.
Got it. Good job in the low post.
A fluid athlete who runs the floor with precision. Lauren makes her presence felt pretty much whenever she's out on the court.
Now here's Taurasi. Hit that time. Alicia Clark with the defensive effort. Inside. Howard. And a foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot two. It's going to go on Brittany Griner.
Natasha Howard taking two shots.
And she makes the first. And good on both. Phoenix leading. Taurasi. Outside, Diggins Smith. Shot clock at six. Off the mark, and the drought continues.
And the fast break for the Storm.
Stewart with the bucket. And that makes it a tie ball game.
Look, a big part of being a dominant scorer is coming through with big buckets for your team. Stewart simply thrives under pressure.
Timeout called the Mercury.
They'd seen enough scoring in the paint and wanted to send a message to their team. Lock things up inside.
Yeah, you're right, Tim. I guarantee you this talk centers around cutting down on all those points coming against them in the paint.
And maybe it's more help, it's the front of player. They've got to try something.
Player of the game, Brittany Griner.
It's become all too familiar. Another night of double-digit rebounds for her. She is so energetic on the glass, and really, it's like this every night. She never lets up when it comes to her work on the boards.
Out of bounds, it'll go to the Storm.
Unless the pass at that distance hits you squarely in the hands, it's a tough one to pull in.
Now a timeout called by Seattle.
Coach saw the players were getting winded and called time to give them a quick breather.
Here is Stewart. Breland defending. Pass to Lloyd. To take the lead. No luck on that one. And the Mercury going the other way now. Here's Coffey. That one's off. Still out of sync. To the middle. Stewart. Oh, baby. They get it and they take the lead.
A shot like that is in Stewart's comfort zone. That's just the result of her determination and really more so her confidence.
Now here's Barassi. For Howard. And right on target. Good.
A reliable player with ice in her veins. Barassi will not be denied for her teammates.
Outside Stewart. Mark outside. Canada. Here's Diggin Smith. And Brianna Stewart with the block.
Phenomenal defense from Stewart on that play. It's no surprise she's regarded as one of the best shot blockers in the league.
What a bucket. Will Lloyd ask for the ball in these situations? Such a rare quality.
Now here's Barassi. That's in for fifth field goal of the game. Makes her 5 for 12 thus far.
Killer instinct. I mean, Taurasi steps her game up in clutch situations. She wants to win at all costs.
Stewart misses. Diana Taurasi on the wing. Covered by Lloyd. Up top, Diggin Smith. Back to Taurasi. Clock at 4. Lloyd. Taurasi's shot is off. 3 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Now here is Stewart. He's tightly guarded. Raises up. They get it back.
Major bucket from Howard. She's great in the clutch. Remember, she won back-to-back WNBA titles with different teams.
And the Mercury call time here. What's your take, guys?
They need a three here, so they need to make sure they summon all their best shooters, because with under 2 seconds remaining, you have to catch it and shoot quick.
Diana Taurasi. Oh, had a chance there to send it to OT, but they came up empty-handed. And so the big win by Seattle in a tight game.